Welcome! In this video we will create a screaming and growling bass with Zebra 2. Let's take the tour! Okay, so I got a request to do a video on Zebra 2. Somebody asked me if it can scream and growl as the Serum plugin. So in this video we're going to see if we can make it scream. Here we have a little demo where I've only used Zebra 2 as the main synthesizer. So we're going to first take a little listen here. There are some screams and a few growls. Okay, so all synthesizers in that sample was created with Zebra. Open up the Zebra. To initialize Zebra, you go up here in the main window here and scroll down and select this init patch. And now we have a blank preset with only one oscillator, which is a sawtooth. And we can switch between the oscillators at the bottom here. So let's select the first one and switch it to spectromorph. We will change the rendering to crisp, which will generate more high-end frequencies. We can look at the spectrum analyzer to be able to see what happens during this synthesizing session. If we set it to soft, you can see that we have a little bit of lag in the upper range. And if we set it to crisp, it generates the full range of upper harmonics. But we're probably not able to hear those, but for the sound generation, sound design here, it can be helpful. Then we go and normalize the waveform a little bit. And we activate the glide. A little note here, so we have some note information to work with. Okay, so a growl or a scream bass is never static. There's always some movement in the sound, and we have some pitch modulation and other kinds of modulation. But we will begin just by adding a little bit of pitch modulation. So we have this bass moving a little bit. Maybe a little bit faster like that. And then go down for this part for a short bit. And now we will start to add some filters to this. So we can use the basic VCF filter, or we can use the more powerful XMF filter, which is a multi-mode filter. So we go and change that to bandpass 2. And we will change this to the XMF mode and increase the resonance slightly. Now we will do some setups here in some macro setups in Serum. Let's go to XY1 and drag this target to our cutoff. And now we can change the range for how the cutoff will be changed with this macro. And it's the X1, which is this controller. And if we move that in the X range, we get it as a parameter in BITWIG, so we can add a little bit of modulation here, or automation. I'm so used to saying modulation because we have a lot of modulation in BITWIG. So maybe we want to do some kind of, yeah, a little bit of this and a little bit of that and a little bit of rising up here. And yeah, you can experiment to make this into a cool screaming bass. So we can change this and try a serial or parallel. Add a little bit of overdrive. Then we can go back to our oscillator and solo it again. And we can go to the oscillator effects of Zebra and add some exophase maybe. Oh. Or if we want to add more upper harmonics, we can use Shoplift to make this a brighter oscillator. Then we can also connect this x-axis to our Shoplift. Just a little bit, and try another oscillator effect. You can experiment with these and get very nice results. Let's just let's see here. Fractals. Maybe also connect that x-axis to this one. Experiment with the FM a little bit to get some grittiness. And we can widen the bass by changing the offset for this multimode filter. If you want to spread the sound in the stereo field, bump up that to two oscillators. Now we can add a second filter here. Use a VCF1 and make that into a high pass filter. Then we need to move this cutoff so we have the parameter available here in BITWIG as automation. Then we can make this ramp up a little bit so we have even more movement here in the sound, because these basses have a lot of movement. And now what we will do is actually remove the low end completely of this first oscillator, because we're going to add the sub bass with the second oscillator. So we can add a VCF2 and set that to high pass mode and drag it down so we just get rid of that absolute low end. Now we can add a second oscillator here and turn that one into sine by going to spectral blend and just adding one harmonic here in this harmonic editor or partials editor. This is one partial here, but as you can hear, it's playing all the time, all throughout, but we want to connect it to some kind of one of these automations so it follows along with the other bass stuff. So we can see for the X1 here, maybe connect this one to that, to the oscillator 2 volume. So we drag another target here. So now we have the sub bass following along with the growl. Then we can add a few more partials to this sub bass if we want a little bit more high end or a mid range. Then we can go into this first oscillator lane, add a shaper. And add some phasing here. and some compression, because growl bass and scream bass is all about effects. So you usually have a quite a simple oscillator that you begin with. Then you use a lot of effects. Now we are overdriving a little bit, so let's add some peak limiter here so we don't blow our speakers. Then we can make this one move with the LFO if we want. Decrease the rate. So we have that XMF set to bandpass. And now you can experiment with these oscillator effects to get various results, like this with the scrambler. And what you often tend to do is add the OTT at the end of this chain, just to glue everything and get all the frequencies in there, check in check. So you can see you can get quite sharp basses with Zebra if you want. Then we can add some reverb here at the end, very dry, damped. But we got to have a lot more damping, not so long feedback. Then we can go into this X1 edit mode and maybe drag this down. And change the shape a little bit. Let's go into this oscillator effects again and go back and change that to fractals. And connect this X1 to our volume of the first oscillator 2. If we want it to be more tight, then of course you can add more distortions and saturations to get a fatter sound. And now we can just export this and use it as a sample within your track. So that's how you approach the sound design of growl and scream basses, or one way of doing it. Yeah, so I hope this can give you a few ideas how you can create the screaming and growl basses with Zebra 2. If you have any questions on Zebra or BITWIG, please shoot me them in the comments. I have some new merch out, so if you want to grab this cool looking cup, you can check the link in the description here and grab it. And I also have a t-shirt out, the MORNINGDEW Media t-shirt. So if you want to support this channel, be sure to check them out. Now you can continue and watch my next video. Okay, thanks for watching today and see you. Bye bye.